Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with the same topic, nationalism in India, third unit. And here we are going to see the limits of civil disobedience movement. Now, what do you mean by limits? Limits here means the people who did not participate in the civil disobedience movement. Okay. Now, Gandhiji and untouchability. Now, why are we going to do this in this topic, limits of civil disobedience? The thing is, these were the people who were not interested in the civil disobedience movement. Now, why is it so? That is what we are going to discuss. Okay. Now, Gandhiji and untouchability. Social groups were moved by the concept of Swaraj. One such group was the untouchables. The untouchables called themselves Dalit or oppressed. Congress ignored the Dalits and favored Sanatanis. Now, who were the Sanatanis? Sanatanis were the conservative high class society, Hindu society. Now, Gandhiji strived a lot to see that Harijans, the oppressed, that is the Dalits, are given their due respect, and all the occupations, whether it is the work of a bhangi or it is the work of a teacher or a lawyer, anyone for that matter, were equal. And so he wanted the conservative Hindu society to see the Harijans. He called the Dalits as Harijans. Harijans means the children of God. Now, he strived a lot to see that the high class Hindu society respects and treats the Dalits as one among them. But he did a lot of work for that. He used to live along with them in the same family. In the same locality where the bhangis used to live. Bhangis are nothing but the sweepers. Okay, the sweepers were called as bhangi. And he used to recite with them, eat along with them, clean the toilets along with them, so that he wanted to prove to the high class Hindu society that no work is lower or no work is a dirty work. Everyone has to do all the works and everyone are to be treated as one. And so he did this to prove to the high class Hindu society. But the Dalits were not satisfied with Gandhiji, nor they were satisfied with the high class Hindu society, because they were afraid that their position is not going to change even if they get independence or without independence. So there were some Dalit leaders, and one among them was B.R. Ambedkar. Okay, now they started to form their own community, gathering their own Dalits as one, and they began organizing themselves, and they started demanding reserved seats in educational institutions and a separate electorate that could choose Dalit members for legislative councils. Now, what was this separate electorate? Separate electorate means the Dalits itself will stand in election, and the Dalit members or the Dalit society only will cast the vote. That means it is not a general election. Only the Dalits are allowed. So this Gandhiji was not willing to give or not willing to offer the separate electorate. So B.R. Ambedkar, formed an association of what? Depressed class association. Now, this association was organized in 1930, and Ambedkar asked Gandhiji for a separate electorate, and Gandhiji was not interested in accepting the demand. Although Gandhiji fasted unto death so that he does not give separate electorate, but he had to agree for one of the demands of Ambedkar, and that was reserved seats in the provisional and central legislative councils. For this he agreed, because Ambedkar was not going to accept anything less than that, and so they had to sign a contract and a pact which was called as the Pune Pact 1932. Now, according to this Pune Pact, there will not be a separate electorate, but yes, the depressed class will be getting seats, reserved seats in the educational institutions, in the provisional and the central legislative councils. So, now what was Gandhiji's fear was that if he gives the Dalits a separate electorate, there are several other political organizations or there are several other communities which would ask for a separate electorate. That was his fear. And his fear came true when Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the Muslim League leader, asked for a separate electorate. Now, Gandhiji immediately refused, saying that he had not given it for the Dalits, the separate electorate, and so he is not willing to give it for the Muslim League as well. So, Muhammad Ali Jinnah immediately asked for the reserved seats as he had given to the Dalits. Now, before Gandhiji could address something regarding the reserved seats, Mr. M. R. Jaikar, he was the member of the Hindu Mahasabha. Okay, now he refused to give separate electorate, he refused to give reserved seats, and he said that the Muslim League is not going to get anything. Now, this angered Muhammad Ali Jinnah, because he expected that they'll be getting a reserved seats, but when that also was refused, he felt that the Muslims in India were not at all secure even if they get independence. And that was the main reason that the Muslims did not participate in the civil disobedience movement. Now, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, he asked now for a separate country itself. Why? Because he felt that his Muslims are not at all secure in India, and so now he asked for separate country itself. Although Gandhiji was not at all willing to give a separate country, there were too many communal violence and many people were dying. Although Gandhiji fasted for almost 28 days, but still they were not ready to compromise, and so Gandhiji had to give in, and unwantedly, Gandhiji had to give the separate country, a willingness for the separate country, and so the Pakistan was formed. So this is the end of the unit 3, and we will be doing unit 4 as well in the next session. And along with this, I have given you the worksheet also. Please complete the worksheet in the classwork, and the activity you can do it in the notepad. Okay, thank you, children. Bye for now.